So what we're doing here is a pedal shootout between three pedals, three chorus pedals. One is an analog MF108M cluster flux Mooger Fooger. It does a flanger and a chorus and all kinds of crazy stuff. We're just going to focus on a normal chorus, lush chorus setting. Then it's going up against Boss CH1 digital chorus and TC Electronic Corona digital chorus. So we got one analog Bucket Brigade chip chorus with a delay time that ranges from 0.6 milliseconds to 10 milliseconds. So that's what you're about to hear right now. Analog modulation. I have the delay time set to 3. The feedback is set to 1. We got it on a sine wave. The rate is between 0.2 and 0.8, so I'm not sure what point that would make it. And then we got the amount on 8. So we're gonna switch off of that and switch on to the super chorus, which I have set to the full chorus setting on it, and it's gonna sound like this. Super chorus CH1. We're going to switch to the Corona chorus on the chorus setting. There's three different settings on this. You got your chorus, your tone print, and your tri chorus. This is what it sounds like on the chorus setting. Okay, that was the chorus setting. We're going to switch to the tri-chorus setting. We're going to listen to some three-note stuff like this. Listen to the same thing on the Boss Super Chorus.
I
Same thing on here. Once again, on the tri chorus setting, we're just going to do a little bit of lead guitar, let you hear what the sounds like. On the tone print default setting, it would sound a little bit like this. The super chorus. And see what happens if I turn the feedback all the way up. Craziness. That's why we keep the feedback dial back. If it went the other way. Turn the delay up all the way. A little bit too psychedelic there. At 8 it would be about this. Just a little bit too trippy. At 6. So yeah, we keep it between 3 and 4, it just seems. Good modulation for the delay time and the feedback round 1. If we really wanted to get crazy with some different some different style. We can flip the rate up and put it on the random LFO. LFO means low frequency oscillator. So basically we got your random, your reverse and reverse sawtooth and sawtooth step, and then the sine wave. Basically these are on sine waves, I believe. And so yeah, what the chorus is doing is you can hear. It's on random with the rate up reverse sawtooth, it sound like this. Almost like rotating speaker vibe when you turn it way up. So that's just some of the stuff this pedal can do. Obviously you really wouldn't want to mess with that too much for a standard chorus sound. So we keep it dialed back rate wise below 0.8. Nice pretty lush modulation. Analog. Honestly, for the price difference in these pedals, I feel like the Boss Super Chorus, if you just want a regular standard chorus sound for a digital chorus, it sounds pretty good, and you can get this used for about $50 at any guitar center, reverb.com, eBay. The cool thing about the Corona Chorus is you can download into it any sound through the tone print and have it there in the middle. So you got your tri chorus, you got your regular chorus, and then you get your tone print in the middle, which you can put, like I said, Brent Hines, Clean Toes, Andy Summers, Walking on the Moon. Like, there's tons of different tone prints you can put. The default chorus tone print sounds like this. If you really want to get the depth a little bit different, that does sound good to have the depth up a little bit more than 12 o'clock. I'm gonna try chorus as well. Again, on the Moog, we're just gonna do one last chord progression real fast. So you can hear the analog modulation. a nice lush analog chorus. That's the Boss Super Chorus. And one more thing I want to say is that the Corona Chorus is in stereo. Stereo ins and stereo outs. The Boss Chorus has only one in, but you can go stereo output as well with the chorus, which is awesome. And the Cluster Flux, if you look at the back, it has 1,000 different things you can do with it, and one of them is stereo ins and outs. So all three pedals are great.